All I know is I was at the premiere. I was sitting in the theater watching the video, and when that 50-50 came on screen, you know, it did. It just, I think the collective skateboarding world was just cracked at that point, because like, I know for a fact everyone in the theater was just like, oh my God, you know, like, it was at the time, it was the gnarliest thing ever, you know, the gnarliest thing I've ever done. That's the one thing that shot Pat Duffy into everyone's life.
Like, when I first saw it, I couldn't believe it. Like, I couldn't believe it was humanly possible to do that stuff back in 91, you know?
I saw the video, right? And I looked at my skateboard. I was like, all right, if he has normal trucks like that, and it's a round bar, like, there's nothing, like it can lock into anything, or it just doesn't work.
For the longest time, I thought that the double kink grind was fake. I thought that it was like, I didn't think it was possible, so I just figured that they did it with like some sort of tricks, or I don't know. I thought he was riding down a ramp, like a rail in the background or something.
I started realizing how gnarly it was, everything that like Pat and Plan B guys did, you know, how gnarly the video was. Because skating just went absolutely shit after that.
At age 16, Pat made a Sponsor Me tape, and it fell into the hands of Mike Tarnaski, co-founder of a new company called Plan B. Tarnaski came up to San Francisco to meet with Pat.
Actually, I met Tarnaski at Embarcadero, and I remember him coming up to me and go, hey, you're Pat. I was supposed to meet him there, and he's all, I could tell by your style. And I was like, okay, that's cool. And I filmed some stuff down the 7 with him that day. That was the first time I ever met Mike.
Within a week, Plan B flew Pat to San Diego to meet the team for the first time.
So they flew him down here, and we went and skated at the San Pasqual High School in Escondido. Within hours of skating at that session that day, he had done two of the craziest things that I had seen at that time, for sure. He grinded the rail out in front of that school, which was like 20 stairs. It was just straight down. He did it like that, no hesitation either. And the rail that's on the bank, too, that thing is deadly. He just did that, like, right off the bat.
You wanted the rest of the guys to respect you, because, like,
you
look who you were with. Danny Way and Sean Sheppy. You better not be a puss.
And the craziest thing is when Pat was doing all the gnarliest stuff, he wasn't even sponsored. Like, he was just getting on Plan B. And that was the stuff that got him on Plan B.
Yeah, he did all that day. He wasn't even on the team. That was like his, that was him trying to get, basically get on the team.
Whoever was pro around then probably seen this kid who came out as an amateur and realized that they better get their act together.
It was depressing because I was like, you know, I suck now compared to that. Like, what am I going to do?
With that video part, it was like, it wasn't just one thing that stood out, you know? It was like the whole thing.
After shooting a sequence for Transworld, Pat came back with Tarnaski to film the same trick. Unfortunately, it started to rain.
It just happened to start raining, and I just got so bummed out, because like, he was there, the man. I had to show them, you know, show my boss.
I went there like a year and a half ago. I looked at that rail and I was like, I don't think there's like anyone could do it now. You know, there's not a lot of people that could backside Smith grind through that thing.
Backside nose one slides back then. People like just started redoing them like 2 years ago. Backside Smith grind and 10 stair handrails. Grinding like the steepest rail and then slapping a curb just right after. It's so raw.
Basically, he was the first person to do that. And that's like paved the way for any other skateboarders to do it now.
He opened the doors for everybody, and you know, and then that was it. Everybody knew it was doable, so all you had to do was sort of follow in his footsteps, you know.
So for me, like, it surfaced like 5 years later when I, you know, started trying to push myself in the direction that Pat had already explored years before. You know, Pat broke down all the doors, and I don't know what motivation and what determination he was going on. We know it's possible because Pat did it. But why, how does Pat know it's possible?
Just seeing him lock into 50-50s on huge handrails was pure inspiration. Inside the squares.
Yeah, it was something that really influenced me a lot. And I didn't think, you know, whatever, like, I want to get to that level, but I definitely wanted to sort of, you know, skate things like that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it definitely, yeah, it definitely influenced me a lot.
Pat wouldn't have explored and conquered, you know, the types of handrails and the gnarly stuff that he did back then. There's no way people would be doing it now.
And it's videos like that and sections like Pat Duffy's that affect skating in that way.
And then all throughout the year since the video, as far as anything else about Pat Duffy, he's the nicest guy ever. He's one of the skaters that I think skateboarding should be like, you know? He's just nice, he's just slacked down for skating, cool guy, you know? I love him.